Hello everyone, my name is Dmitry Kotelnikov. I'm from company iPhoneWeb, which builds media trading platforms. I would like to talk about Lua pitfalls. This report will be useful for the beginners to Lua, especially who already have habits for other language, because your old habits may not work in Lua, but this fact may be hidden for a while. So this report about small but dangerous mistakes that may have serious consequences. It based on real events, so the list of the pitfalls is not exhaustive. Usually you have to make an error by yourself to learn something from it. And so I sometimes like to imagine that it's me who made this mistake and feel the error to prevent it in the future. But actually, it doesn't mean that it's me who made all the errors which I will present. I have a small and modest goal that some people will bypass a couple of pitfalls that are presented here. If you really experienced, maybe everything that will be presented is not useful for you, but it may be still useful for some of your friends or colleagues. So you may show this presentation to them and save their time and nerves. IPhoneWeb is a custom-built real-time trading platform. And we have dozens of Lua developers and even more Lua projects. Our platform is well divided into components and teams, so the Lua team mostly engaged in business logic, and so the code in single project is quite compact. Also, Lua is quite easy language to learn, and the newcomers integrate into the development process very quickly, and sometimes too quickly. IPhoneWeb allows to scale the business logic into billions of the requests. For sure, everything is relative, but opportunity to break billions of something is really fascinating. it's worth to mention how our company treats the errors. In some way, it gives you opportunity to be on your fingers, to feel by yourself how it's important to be careful with such many requests. Every major mistake is thoroughly considered, and it's decided how to prevent it in the future. So my first example is very well known and easy. It's kneeling tables. Everyone knows that kneeling table removes the key. Every novice knows it, and but this behavior may be not so usual for the developer, and so unintentionally he still writes the code as in the other language like Perl, where undev doesn't remove the key. So okay, I know that Neil removes the key, and I write some code like this, and assign, when I want to delete some key, I just remove it to the new, and then I may get this value and get the new. And so for a while I feel like everything is okay, and may miss the point that new is not always what I really need. So let's make an error to understand this. Okay, assume that I used Perl previously, and I dislike conditional logic and use undefined everywhere where possible. So, and also suppose I have MongoDB and I need to remove a user. So I write this code and suppose that everything will be okay, that it removes the user. But after the deployment, everything goes wrong and the database is empty. So I removed all the users. I feel bad about this. We have to use backups and all other stuff. But good thing that now I'll remember that I should be careful with Neil. Why I remove all the users? Just because self-user ID may be new. So this query is transposed to an empty query and I remove everything. So just as a little excuse for such an error, I may say that in Perl, this query transforms to this, and actually nothing is removed. So this old habit worked previously, but now it has to be changed. And the main problem is that your habits are some unconscious thing, and you can't reflect for a while that they don't work anymore. Okay. So, how to bypass this pitfall? For the first time, when you learn Lua and start to use it for the first weeks, just check every table you created for the condition if the absence and undefined value is the same for your logic. Is this really doesn't matter, or it really matters? If the absence is not the same as new values, then introduce some checks or use a dedicated object that will represent undefined value. Also, to prevent removing all your database, just restrict queries to the database. For example, deny queries without ID. So the mistake is very small, but the consequences are very big. Here is another reason to avoid global variables. Suppose I have habits for Apache, where all requests are consequent. I mean that requests are processed one after another. In this case, global variables are still bad style of coding, but they work. Now we have our own server, and it creates a routine for every request. So I'd like to tell you about some mistake. It's very beautiful, I think, because it may the, all synthetic tests may pass. You may even deploy your code to the server with small traffic and check the values, and they will be okay. And you may even deploy your code to the huge traffic and see the statistic of the values, and everything will be still okay. So looks like okay, and this code may work for a while. But actually, as a large number of data is incorrect. So the question how it may happen. The answer is here is in yields. The request during its processing may call yield, and so the control passed to the other request. And then back to the first request, and then to the second, then again to the first, and so on. So requests are overlapped. If you use global variables in this case, the data may transfer from one request to the other. It is not what you really want. Namely, for example, you have a global variable user. Maybe you just wanted really global variable to get access it from everywhere, or just forget the local. It doesn't matter. And you set the value for it. Here's the gender. and then you call some API that may call yield. And so the control pass to the other request, then it's resume, and you probably get user values from the other request. So, and this way you may have nearly depending on the load and on how the traffic is, how much the traffic, nearly everything may be wrong, but the statistic may will still be the same because the data just interchanged and the values are still the same. So the very fast solution without any global variables or environment is just use some variable context that will contain every frequently used object that you need. Namely user profile, login, and so on, and then just pass them it manually from the object to the object. This requires a lot of manual work, but once you done this, you may add anything to the context, and this, it will be local for the coroutine. Also, it's nice to make global environment read-only because for here this is just an idea, not for production ready code, but even this simple code prevents you from using global variables, and even may save you from another type of error when you declare a local variable and then misspell it and it became global. So if you restrict global variables to change global variables, this here the code will raise an error. This one is just few ideas that I get in an hour. So actually we have
production ready solution that is written in C, but I didn't dig into it and just imagine how this may be done in pure Lua. For example, in Lua 5.2, you may just save the global environment before yield and then restore it after the yield. And so the data won't be mixed. The next simple idea is to store coroutine variables in some index, in index global variables by coroutine running, so they will be also separated. And the third one is to use set global environment and get not global coroutine environment and get coroutine environment. Maybe there are some more robust solutions, so you're welcome to tell me about them or in person or in the questions. Okay. The next error happened because function declaration order is really crucial, and this is not also usual for the developers that came for that used to the other languages. 5 minutes. Okay. It's well known that function is first class, class value, and all that I catch is that I may easily pass and get functions, but I didn't catch that now I have to take care about the declaration order. And okay. Let's suppose that we this is based on real story when we didn't have official coding style, and so the code was written in some different styles. At first, it was written with local function, and so the order is crucial, and then the other developer just decided that it's more readable to at first call the functions and declare. So it he removed local and pulled the declaration down. Then again, the code passed to the original developer and he just added local. And so this code is broken. And this is another variation of how you may break the code by the wrong order. When you for the first time everything was okay, but then you again used normalize in the function setup and the code again is broken. So the solution is to use official coding style, so every developer will know how to write and won't change from one solution to the other. Our main requirement was independence of the function declaration order, so we have such variant with pre-declaration like in C, and I really like this variant, but it actually it was rejected because it seemed too complex for the developers, and we just proceed with parallel style with underscores without any local. So the next example is pretty funny and not so dangerous, not so okay, it may be dangerous. Okay, at some time I see that it happens that somebody missed the comma between the call of the log function. Maybe here was a double declaration or something like that. And at first glance, it even seemed that the code should work. The log is called, and okay, here is the comma, but it will work. But actually, the log is called, but the width is always nil. it's very funny as for me. It's nil or another global value. So the solution here is again coding style, to introduce code beautifier that will automatically format your code. So this code will look like this, and the error will be really obvious. Here are some pitfalls with typing. I have little time, so I just list them. You have to remember that case may have any type. This is also unusual for other languages, and so you should be careful about which type of key do you use when you call the function. Also, it's crucial when you try to convert the data from the other language. So just use objects to emulate types of Lua, and don't try to create smart solutions fast. Okay, the next thing is that there is no type array. And this is crucial when you convert your data to the JSON. I've seen some implementations that try to detect if this should be an array or not. Don't try to do this, just declare explicitly what you want, array or not. Another type in error that I encountered is that value may change the type. It's common for all languages with dynamic typing, and so it's just want to mention here that when you get the data from outside, you should validate it, because even numeric IDs may pass as strings. Okay, so just validate of all the types. And so here are my list of pitfalls that I will always pass because I did a presentation with them. Okay. So a little bit of recommendations. Just take much care about differences between languages. Share your knowledge with colleagues. Use coding style, and make your code more reliable than it's needed right today, because tomorrow the conditions may change, and you hardly will reflect what habits will become harmful. And have fun with errors. Just talk about them with your friends, and tell about how you may quietly but firmly broke the production. Okay, thanks.
I find it curious that you didn't mention holes and tables.
I really mentioned about them here.
Ah, okay.
Nil in areas.
So it's breaks. Not that important to include, in your opinion, to include in the main list of the pitfalls?
Actually, I didn't account with serious consequences of this in my experience. Yes, some I mentioned about this, but
okay. I see that you use Lua 5.2 in production. Is it correct?
No, we use actually Lua JIT.
I wanted to make a case that Lua 5.2 handles a lot. Roberto tells me that I promote Lua JIT too much.
Okay. Have you considered writing tests for your applications?
Yes, we
because of this list, more than half of them you could detect with the most simple test in the world. You could detect that JSUB doesn't not make in place replacement, that function may change passed table, that there is no type array, condition is false only given new or false. I mean, most of these very simple tests would detect this. Some of them are really subtle, but some of them are, you just write a test and...
Okay, thank you for your for your question. Actually, we always write tests, and nearly all the mentioned cases were tested, except the order of the functions. We have, in average, 85% of coverage. I've written some simple tools that calculates it, and we always do this. But sometimes 85% is not 100%, first of all. And also, for example, global variables just don't catch because of the consecutive requests. This has tests, but we always has single user.
So this one is the most horrible. I mean, in Perl, it behaves in the correct way. If you don't give a user, it does nothing. In Lua, why? I mean, the API is broken. It's not. You don't give a user, and then I don't know who to delete, so I'm going to delete everybody just in case. That's the
yes. But it's hard to reflect. The
API is broken. That one in particular has nothing to do with Lua. Lua has many pitfalls, but that is not one of
that's,
them.
That's not Lua pitfalls as a language. That pitfalls. Of the developers, maybe of the habits of the developers, because
I don't understand the habit. Because in Perl, you said in Perl, if you don't give the ID, it doesn't remove anything.
It doesn't remove anything.
Yes. And why in Lua? I mean, why you change the API to Lua? Why in Lua you do remove something when you? Why you change the meaning of the
in
function?
Lua, we get empty table, and so when you create query db user remove is empty table, it will remove everything.
But why? Why is it the ORM behaves this way in Lua?
Yeah.
What's the reason? That's a bug.
Suppose that you really have to remove everything. What query will you write?
I don't know. Don't use ORM. ORM is harmful.
It's
you
not
can see.
An ORM. It's just quite thin API to the MongoDB.
Okay.
Imagine in Unix, you do remove, and you forget to give the file name. And then you remove all files.
He just didn't forget the file. If you,
I'm sorry. Well, we are out of time. I apologize. Okay. We can continue in the lobby.